Hello students, welcome to Academia. Today I will discuss small intestine. The small intestine is an organ of GIT where the digestion and most of the absorption processes are going on. The small intestine lies between the stomach and large intestine, and it is about 18 feet, that is 6 meters long. And in the structure of small intestine, there are many folds to adjust to the abdominal cavity. The length of the small intestine can vary greatly from as short as 3 meter to as long as 6 meter. And the typical length in a living person is 3 meter to 6 meter. The length depends both on how tall the person is and how the length is measured. So, now the location of the small intestine. So, generally we know that the small intestine is present in the abdominal cavity. It is surrounded by large intestine. And the muscular tube extending from the pyloric sphincter to the ileocecal valve. So it is the extension from the pyloric sphincter to the ileocecal valve. The small intestine is divided into three parts. The first part is called duodenum, the second part is called jejunum, and the last part is called ileum. Duodenum, which is called the first part, jejunum is the middle part, and ileum is the last part of small intestine. Duodenum is C-shaped. The length of duodenum is 25 centimeters. It is attached to the stomach. In mammals, the duodenum may be the principal site for the iron absorption. In the duodenum, there are certain parts. The superior part is a continuation from the pylorus. Next, the descending part, it begins at the superior duodenal flexor, where the pancreatic duct and common bile duct enter into it. We know that the pancreas is adjacent to the duodenum. The ducts from pancreas, which carries pancreatic juice, enters into that descending part of duodenum, as well as the bile duct which carries the bile. It gives the bile to the descending part of duodenum. Then the horizontal part. It begins at the inferior duodenal flexor. The superior mesenteric artery and vein are anterior to this part. The next part is the ascending part, which passes upward, joining with the jejunum at the duodeno-jejunal flexor. So, in the duodenum also, physiologically, there are four parts: superior part, descending part, horizontal part, and number four, ascending part. So, these four parts constitute the duodenum. There are different type of cells and glands are also present in the duodenum. Histologically, duodenum having four layers, as well as the jejunum, ileum also having the four layers. From inside to outwards, the layers are mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa, and serosa. So, the innermost layer of the duodenum is mucosa. Next, submucosa. Then the muscularis externa, and the outermost layer is called serosa. So, histologically, if we see, the duodenum have four layers. Both Brunner's glands and goblet cells in the duodenum secrete mucus. The Brunner's glands are alkaline and helps to neutralize the acid chyme which is produced by stomach. The glands which are present in duodenum, the most important gland is Brunner's gland, which are compound tubular submucosal glands. Then the crypts of Leberkuhn, which is a gland found in between the villi in the intestinal epithelium and named after the German anatomist Johann Nathanael Leberkuhn. So, according to the name of the scientist, the crypts of Leberkuhn are named. Now, the villus. The plural form is villi, which are small, slender vascular projections that increase the surface area of a membrane. In the small intestine, whether it is duodenum, jejunum, or ileum, are characterized by these villi. Each villus is approximately 0.5 to 1.6 mm in length and has many microvilli, and which collectively form the brush border. Each of these microvilli are about 1 mu m in length, around 1000 times shorter than a single villus. The intestinal villi are much smaller than any of the circular folds in the intestine. The villi helps in the absorption process of the intestine. The duodenum is largely responsible for the breakdown of the food in the small intestine using enzymes. The duodenum also regulates the rate of emptying of the stomach via the hormonal pathways. The villi of the duodenum have a leafy looking appearance, which is a histologically identifiable structure. Generally, when we identify the slides of duodenum, the villi are found, which indicate the structure of small intestine. In the next slides, we will go through the structure of villi and microvilli's brush border, so that you can easily understand the physiology of the villi. The next parts of small intestine are jejunum and ileum. The jejunum begins at the duodeno-jejunal flexor. Together, both are 5 to 7 meters long and are greatly coiled. They are covered to varying extents by the greater omentum. Histologically, like duodenum, jejunum and ileum also having 4 layers. The 4 layers from inside outwards are mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa and serosa. The jejunum also contains very few number of Brunner's glands or Peyer's patches. However, there are few jejunal lymph nodes suspended in its mesentery. The jejunum has many large circular folds in its submucosa, which is called plica circularis. The plica circularis is the most important identifying features of jejunum. It increases the surface area for the nutrient absorption. The villi of the jejunum look like long finger-like projections and are another histological identifying character of jejunum. So, plica circularis is an important structure which is present in the jejunum. The villi are also present in jejunum as well as in ileum. The jejunal villi are more larger, thicker, leaf-like, whereas the ileum having less villi, shorter, thinner and finger-like projections. There are some other differences also present between jejunum and ileum. So in the next slide, we will go through the other differences between them. The lining of jejunum is specialized for the absorption by the enterocytes of small nutrients. Once the nutrients are absorbed, they pass from the enterocytes into the enterohepatic circulation. The next structure present are called Peyer's patches. These are nothing but the groupings of lymphoid follicles in the mucous membrane of ileum. They are oval or rectangular in shape and more prominent in ileum part. They are characterized by the specialized M cells. The Peyer's patches are formed by the aggregation of lymphatic vessels. The Peyer's patches are named after the Swiss anatomist Johann Conrad Peyer. Because the lumen of GIT is exposed to the external environment, much of it is populated with potentially pathogenic microorganisms. The Peyer's patches thus establish their importance in the immune system of the intestinal lumen and help in the production of the immune response within the mucosa. So, in the mucus layer of the ileum, basically, the Peyer's patches are more prominent and they also providing the immunity to the GIT. In the next slides, we will go through the functions of small intestine. The three parts like duodenum, jejunum and ileum all are concerned with digestion as well as much more absorption process of the nutrients. The villi present in these three parts of intestine helps in this absorption process smoothly.